Hi everyone and welcome back to another Placeit tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you step by step how to create YouTube thumbnails like these ones that you see here. And additionally, if you don't have a Placeit subscription, I'll show you how you can create YouTube thumbnails on Placeit completely for free. With that being said, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so in this video, we're going to be focusing on creating YouTube thumbnails. Now, first things first, this is going to be a tutorial using Placeit.net, and if you are new to Placeit, just know that it is a paid website, so you do have to pay to get a subscription. With that being said, I did share my affiliate link to Placeit in the description down below, and that comes with a 15% discount code. So if you don't have a subscription to Placeit already, feel free to use that link, it'll give you the discount, and it also helps out this channel since it is my referral link to Placeit. Now with that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started with this tutorial. The first thing we're going to do is hover over designs and go to YouTube templates. And from here, it's going to bring us to all of the different YouTube templates. So what we need to do is click the down arrow and switch it to thumbnail specifically. And from here, it's going to show us over 200 different thumbnails that we can customize. And as you hover over them, it shows you some variations of different options you could create. Now, something that I definitely recommend to you from experience here is to click the down arrow on the left and switch it to best selling, or even look at the newest ones. And this will generally give you the best options in this category. So we can choose any of these. And quite frankly, I like this one. So this is the one I'll use for this example. All we've got to do is click this. And once we're on this page, we're officially in the thumbnail editor. Now, a couple things to cover here. We'll start on the left side. These are all text boxes and they correspond with what is over on the side. So as you can see, this box over here corresponds to this writing. Now, since we move this text, there's no way to go back directly. So if we do reset layout, it'll bring it back to the original starting point. Now, additionally, on this text, you can change it to say whatever you need to. You can change the font right from this dropdown. You can change the color of the text as well. Now, if there's a section of the text that you really don't want, for example, this line down here, all you have to do is turn it off. Now, once we turn that back on, for instance, if we did want to add another section of text, all we have to do is add another text. It'll bring it right into here. We can change the size to however big or small we need it. We can even change out the background of it so we don't have a text background at all. And as you can imagine, you can change everything to customize it just like the others. Now, since we don't need this in this example, I'm going to go ahead and just turn that back off. And now we've covered all of the text options on the left here. Moving over to the right side, just starting from the top, you're going to see on different templates, you have different options. So on this template, we have a line color, which is corresponding to this little line right here. So if we do want to change that, we can change it to any color that we want. Now, if you need a very specific color, not just for the line, but for anything on Placeit, for example, this might be your brand's colors. You can go to more, and then you can type in the color right here, or you can find it through here. Just make sure that when you set this little option, you choose choose, and then it will apply it to the color. Now, once you're set choosing the line color, we can continue to move along. Now, this specific template comes with a gradient, which is coming over from the right side and getting more faint as it comes to the left. Now, we can change the color of this gradient if we want to. We can change it to anything that we want. Now, once you've set your color here, we can click off of this and continue to move down. Now, in this instance, we have a background option, which is a color, but it won't matter for this if we change it. We have no background showing behind this image, so this isn't actually going to come into play on this specific example. Now, speaking of that image, as we look at this image, it's taking up the entire thumbnail, and that image is coming from this selection here. So you can type in any topic that you'd like to. Sticking on the fitness, we'll scroll down and you can change this to any of these images. Just know that any image that you choose here comes with full commercial usage rights. This means that you can use the image in your thumbnails and actually profit from your YouTube channel. Keep in mind that not all design tools come with full commercial usage rights. So needless to say, that is a big advantage to using Placeit.net. Now, as we click through these, if we wanted something different, you can see that you can just click it and it gets applied to the thumbnail. And then you can go back to the original one if you wanted to. But a couple options to know are that you can do no image and it'll apply the background color. You can do a custom image if you want to put in an image that you already have, or you can choose from any of theirs. Now, another really important thing to cover for thumbnails are, what if you want to add your custom logo to all of your thumbnails? Well, all you have to do for that is click add graphic, and it will add a graphic over here. This one is just going to be added by default, and that's corresponding over here, but you would add a custom image and select your logo from your computer. Now, remember, if you added something here and you don't want it to be in here anymore, all you have to click is no image. Now, there's two more really important things you need to know about creating YouTube thumbnails, and that's what I'll show you now. First is, if you scroll down here a little bit, you will see different presets with the same template. So as you can see, there's different backgrounds with different color text, different type of font, and you can kind of browse through different ideas using this same template. Now, if you go beyond that, you will see other templates completely, so you can change it up at any time if you want to try something different. Now, the second thing is I recommend having some kind of consistency through your YouTube thumbnails. The reason you want this is maybe you have your logo on every one of your YouTube thumbnails. So when someone is browsing through YouTube and they see on the suggested side, they see another one of your thumbnails, they recognize that logo and they know that it's your YouTube video. If you make every one of your thumbnails on every video completely different and there's no general theme, people won't be able to recognize them when they're just browsing through YouTube and not specifically on your channel. So my recommendation for this is, for instance, to add your logo to the corner or add it somewhere in your thumbnail and then try to keep that consistent. The best way that I can recommend keeping this consistent is to create a draft. So all you have to do when you're happy with your first thumbnail here is to save it as a draft. All you hit is the little save icon here. It'll load for a second, and then it'll tell you that it's completely saved. Now when you log back onto Placeit the next time to create your next YouTube thumbnail, you can click from the draft, and you can start with all the elements you left off with last time. This allows you to quickly replicate your theme on your thumbnails, and saves you a lot of time in the future. Now as you can see, this is exactly what I do. So if we click on drafts here, and we open that in a new tab, you will see all of my drafts right here. This is the primary one that I use for the YouTube thumbnails. This was the banner for the YouTube channel, and the intro was also created on Placeit. So with that said, when I create new thumbnails for the channel, I come right into this draft and I start editing from there. So the last thing with this thumbnail here is once we're happy with it, all we click is download. And it'll just give us a couple reminders. One, that there are no Placeit watermarks here. The format is a high resolution PNG. The size is 1280 pixels by 720 pixels, which is the perfect ratio for a YouTube thumbnail. And lastly, most importantly, that commercial usage is okay. All we do now is just click download now. And all we have to do is wait a few seconds until we get a check mark in our downloads, and we can click to download it straight to our computer. Now we've got our pop-up right here, and we can simply click to download, and we can open this right on our computer. So just like that, that is the traditional way of creating a YouTube thumbnail using Placeit.net. But now I want to show you how to create a free one if you don't have a subscription to Placeit.net. So all we've got to do for this is come back to Placeit's homepage, and then we'll hover over mockups or designs. Either of these will take you to the same place. We just want to click the free one. It should be the first on both. No matter which one we click, it's both going to take us to this page here. And what this page is Placeit's free page. So they have over 15 pages of free items. And as you can see, scrolling to the bottom, this number will change because they continue adding new free items here for us. But as you see, when we're scrolling through here, none of these are directly YouTube thumbnails. So we're going to come over to the left side and we're going to go to YouTube Banner Maker. Now, something that's pretty interesting is that a YouTube banner and a YouTube thumbnail have the same aspect ratio. So although these are in different formats, you can create a YouTube thumbnail using the banner template. So with that said, we can click any of these and start editing them. And as you can notice, the size of this template is the same as the one before. So now we can start moving these elements around. We can do everything that we were just doing previously, editing the text, adding more text, and doing everything with the graphics on the right side to create a YouTube thumbnail here. And then remember, save it as a draft. And that way, when you come back to Placeit.net for your next YouTube thumbnail, you can just open up the draft and start again. Now, like I said before, this is completely free to do this. So you just click free download. And just like before, even though this is a free download, there are no Placeit watermarks. It is a high resolution PNG. And since this is technically a YouTube banner photo, it is 2560 by 1440 pixels, which is bigger than the traditional YouTube thumbnail. However, the aspect ratio stays the same, so you can use it perfectly as a YouTube thumbnail. And lastly, most importantly, even the free download comes with full commercial usage rights. So all we've got to do here is click free download. Scroll up to the top. Once we get our check mark, we can click here to download, and we can open this on our computer. So as you can see, just like that, we were able to create the traditional YouTube thumbnail and create a free YouTube thumbnail on Placeit.net just by using those two different methods. So guys, that is it for this video. If you have any other questions about Placeit specifically on this video or in general, feel free to let me know down in the comments. And don't forget, if you are going to sign up for Placeit, I've got the affiliate link with the discount code on it linked in the description, so feel free to use that. All right guys, that is it for this Placeit tutorial. I hope it was helpful, and I will be seeing you in the next one.